All right, Shalom.
Shalom.
Of course, first and foremost, before we begin, we want to give all the praises, the glory, and honor to Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh, Shai, Ba'ashem, HaKadosh. We also want to give double honors to our elders and apostles of Great Millstone, the men who rule well, the men who taught us the truth. And a sincere Shalom, Barak, and peace and blessings to the elect of the nation of Israel. All right, and pretty much, you know, we want to go into a video basically talking about, you know, you don't have to fit the stereotype. You know, speaking to Israel, speaking to the elect, you don't have to fit the, we're going to get the definition of stereotype because, you know, I was meditating upon that topic of stereotyping, how Esau puts Jake in a box and, you know, with his witchcraft and then causes Jake to fit a certain stereotype, you know? And, you know, when you come into this knowledge and this truth, all right, Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashem Rakakadash, all right, shows you, okay, that you don't have to fit into Esau's bubble, you know, into his stereotype. You don't have to fit in what he told you. You don't have to fit in the image he made for you, is what I really want to say, okay? And we're going to get into that. We're going to get scriptures on it. So I better go ahead. I'm going to go to stereotype on the Edom Online. It's a noun. It says, I'm going to go straight to the point with it. It says, meaning a stereotype plate. Meaning, image perpetuated without change. All right? And that's exactly what Esau has put on us, man. A specific image perpetuated without change. And perpetuated goes back to perpetuate, which means cause to endure or to continue indefinitely. Right? Because what? He made a specific image for the Negro, Latino, and Native American. All right? That's why when you think of a Negro, the stereotypical Negro, Latino, Native American, there's like a preset for all three of them, all right? Esau has set up little different images for a Negro, Latino, and Native American to fit, you know? Whether he's a gangbanger, all right? A hustler, a pimp, all right? A faggot, you know?
An illegal alien.
An illegal alien, a wetback, all right? Mm-hmm. That's why even the Proverbs, they fit us, so to speak.
The bywords.
Yeah, the Proverbs and the bywords, that's why they fit Jake, because Esau made this image for you to live by, all right? And now Jake fits the stereotype, you know? Regular Joe Schmo, so to speak. You know, an American, that's another template Esau made up for you, for you Israelites out there, man. But when you come into this truth, all right, you break those things. You don't have to fit the stereotype anymore, okay? So we're going to get into some scriptures. Let's start off in Romans 12:2.
Yeah, this is Romans chapter 12, verse 2.
Mm-hmm.
It says, and be not conformed to this world.
Right, because those templates that Esau made up for you, that's part of this world, okay? Go to work, pay your taxes, you know? Not to say we aren't going to do those things while we're in his captivity, but you know what else? You know, be a pimp, be a ball player, be a rapper. Those are the stereotypes he made for you, you know? Mm-hmm. When the scriptures give us already something that we're supposed to be, the image that Yahweh Shai wants us to be is that holy, separate, you know, royal priesthood, man. That's what you're supposed to fit. Those are the guidelines and the template you're supposed to fit, being holy. Because when you're within the Heavenly Father's boundaries, all right, you're truly free, you know? Your spirit can now, you know, we're not fully righteous in this body, but when we're in the kingdom, we're gonna be fully righteous, man. We're gonna be even more full of life, because when you like a wise brother told me, man, you're more alive when you come into the truth, you know.
Yep. Lively stone.
Yeah, we're lively stones, like the scriptures say, you know. So read that, Baba Kasha.
Yeah, again, Romans 12:2,
mm-hmm.
And be not conformed to this world,
uh-huh,
but be transformed by the renewing of your mind.
Right. So you start to break off those stereotypes. Okay. You're no longer a Negro, a so-called Negro. You're no longer a nigga. You're no longer a spick. You're no longer a wetback. You know. You're no longer a whatever they call Gad. You know, timber niggas. You're no longer those things. You know. You no longer fit. That's the old you. That template Esau set for you is the old man. We're gonna get into that. You know. So it said, be transformed by the renewing of your mind, man. So you're going to change, all right, the inward man. The inward man is going to shed off those templates, that image that Esau set up for you, man, which ultimately is to worship him. Because every single one of those things that he set up for you to do, every single one has to play in to him being on top and you under him. And every single one.
Slug. No, slug. Right. You know, and it also promotes death.
Yep.
You know, I also wanted to mention as well, because it's also on the left-hand side and it's on the right-hand side. You know, how you're conforming to the, essentially to the, you're becoming victim to these stereotypes of the of what so-called blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans. But guess what? You can also fall on the stereotypes of what? Judah, Benjamin, and Levi.
Yeah. Oh, that's another thing. That's a that's the balance. Cause what you don't also want to come into the truth and keep that stereotype mentality. Like, okay, I'm a Benjamite, so I have to do what Benjamin does.
Right.
And it's like, relax. You know, you're an Israelite, full of life. You are who the Most High tailored you to be. Let's get that in Sirach 27, 37. Salakia, Sirach 37:27. Because when you come into this as well, you begin to start to know who you truly are, because that wisdom starts to try you and you begin to move a certain way and you learn that certain things that were in the world that you were doing, you shouldn't be doing. All right? So, Baba Kashaw, read.
This is Sirach or Ecclesiasticus 37, 37 and 27. My son, prove thy soul and thy life and see what is evil for it.
Yeah, that's right. And that's going to happen through what? Through the Heavenly Father putting you through trials and tribulations. You know, trying things out. Can I do this? Can I do that? Oh, nah, last time I did that, I spent too much money. Maybe I shouldn't do that, you know? Oh, nah, maybe drinking is not for me, you know? Maybe overindulging in certain things is not for me. Eating certain things and, you know, doing certain things is not for me, you know? That's just an example. Go ahead.
Yep, it says, let me read again. My son, prove thy soul and thy life and see what is evil for it and give not that unto it.
Yeah, so whatever, you know, is evil unto you, you know, don't do it, you know? Oh, I'm gonna mess with a bunch of different women. Nah, it didn't work out for me. You know, I can't do certain things.
But I'm a player. I'm an Israelite.
Yeah, right.
You don't gotta fit that stereotype.
Yeah, you don't need to have a 12-foot-long beard to be righteous.
Yeah.
As well, you know, you don't need to have, you know, the crispiest, you know, braids in the world to be a righteous Israelite. You know, that doesn't make you an Israelite. You don't have to wear a diadem. That doesn't make you righteous. You know, what makes you righteous is your faith in Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, and ultimately, it's, you know, the Lord having mercy upon you and being the elect is what's going to make you righteous ultimately, you know?
Yeah, if I may add, because that's something really from the world. You know, we just read it in Romans, right? You're not supposed to be conformed to this world.
Right.
Well, that same mindset can still be applied in the truth. Mm-hmm. You know, just because you find out you're an Issacharite, that don't mean you got to be drinking, you know,
Corona
all day.
Right. Wearing leather boots.
Yeah, you find out you're a Zebulonite, that don't mean you gotta be good at soccer or something.
Right.
You know, you don't gotta be a diehard soccer fan, man. You know?
Yeah, because those are the worldly stereotypes. Yeah, there's certain things tribes do because it's in their spirit, but ultimately, the real you is serving Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai.
Oh, and the world calls it peer pressure.
Yeah.
You know, it's not about being a crowd pleaser. You know, just be yourself.
Yeah.
You know, because ultimately, if you're trying to do all these things, you're not being yourself.
Exactly.
You're putting up a facade. You're an actor. Essentially.
Yep. A hypocrite.
Yeah.
Can you get the read the next verse?
Verse 28. It says, verse 28, for all things are not profitable for all men.
Yep, exactly, because there's certain things, brothers that have been in the truth longer, or brothers have more experience in certain different places, aspects of their lives that they can do, but you can't handle it yet, you know? And I can say that, you know, from experience, you know, there's certain jobs even in the world that brothers can do because their spirit can handle it, but others can't, you know? Certain, you know, working at certain hours of the day, you know? That's just another example, you know? Different things that some brothers' spirits can handle and some can't. Okay? So, you know, prove thy soul, man. See what is evil unto it, man. Okay? So, we're going to... Lord, we'll end it in Ephesians.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
We're going to finish it out.
Oh, Salakia, go ahead.
Yeah. Sirach 37 and 28, again. For all things are not profitable for all men, neither hath every soul pleasure in everything.
There you go. You know? Just, you know, for example, like, don't try to fit... You know, if you're a Judite, don't try to fit the stereotype of a Judite, you know? You don't have to fit the... And we're speaking about the worldly stereotypes, okay? You don't have to fit the stereotype, Jake. All right? Yeah. You need to simply be who the Heavenly Father made you out to be, because our spirits are tailor-made to be how the Lord wants us to be. And there's certain things that are evil unto you that aren't for the next brother.
Yeah, and if I may say, that goes even with just being honest with yourself. Because, you know, if you're a Judite, a Gadite, and you have some... pleasure, if you actually do have pleasure in some things that may be deemed stereotypical, but your soul actually sincerely has joy in it, then you know, so be it.
Ain't nothing wrong with that.
Ain't nothing wrong, you know, to walk, no problem. You know, but that, and that's actually the problem, you know, with Jake in the world, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know, even when they come to this truth, that they still might have that mindset. And that goes for those, if you think about it, because they never conquered that spirit from the world, man.
Yeah.
You know, from Esau, because they never
He's
noticed
old man.
It. You know, that same goes for those false prophets, man, teaching what, you know, Negro only.
Yeah,
they still have that
nigga mentality.
The black man spirit. They still have
that. Yeah, Salak, if I could say, because what did Elder Apostle Gabar say in the video talking about them? He said their whole world is the ghetto. You know? And that's true. Mm-hmm. Their whole cosmos is the ghetto. That's why they think all Israelites are black, you know, quote unquote. Mm-hmm. You know?
Yeah, you never made it out of the cocoon.
Yeah. Yep. They're not cultured. You know, us in the truth, you know, we know about different cultures and stuff. That's why we're able to discern spirits. That's why we're able to say, oh, that's a heathen. Oh, that's a Jake. You know?
Yeah.
Just an example, but is that it on that one?
Yeah,
okay.
That was it.
Yeah, let's get to Ephesians.
Kind of, this is, this is Ephesians 4, what's that, 17?
Mm-hmm.
No.
Start at 17.
Yeah, I don't think this is it. This is,
Ephesians 4. Yeah, start at 17.
Right. This is Ephesians chapter 4 and 17. Mm-hmm. This I say, therefore, and testify in the Lord, that ye henceforth walk not as other Gentiles walk, in the vanity of their mind.
Yeah, so we aren't to walk as the other Gentiles walk, man. Alright, we're not supposed to walk in the vanity, you know, of our minds, man. Okay? The scriptures say in Romans, that I know that in me, that is in my flesh, dwelleth no good thing. We're not supposed to walk according to, you know, the lust of the flesh, essentially. You know? Mm-hmm. So go ahead. So don't walk like that. You don't have to fit that worldly stereotype, you know? We're not supposed to be niggas, you know? We're not supposed to be spics. We're not supposed to be wetbacks. We're supposed to be Hebrew Israelites, man. All right, serving Yahweh, Yahweh Shai. Go ahead.
Yep. Verse 18, having the understanding darkened, being alienated from the life of the Most High,
mm-hmm.
through the ignorance that is in them,
mm-hmm.
because of the heart.
The blindness.
Or Salaki, because of the blindness of their heart.
Yep, the heart, the mind. You know, they're blinded in their minds, man.
Yep.
All right, go ahead.
Verse 19, who being past feeling have given themselves over unto lasciviousness,
mm-hmm.
to work all uncleanness with greediness.
Mm-hmm. Keep going.
Verse 20, but ye have not so learned Hamashach Yahweh Shai.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 21, if so be that ye have heard of him, Salakia, if so be that ye have heard him and have been taught by him as the truth is in Yahweh Shai.
Right, because Yahweh Shai is, you know, he is the truth, the way, the life,
word.
Man. You know, yeah, go ahead. It comes in the volume of the book. Go ahead.
Yep. Verse 22,
mm-hmm.
it says that ye put off concerning the former conversation.
Yeah, and the word conversation is your manner of life.
Yes.
You know, so we're supposed to put off that old manner of life. That template, that stereotype, you know, tying it all back, you know, to how we started. That template, that stereotype that Esau made for you, shed that off, man. All right? Shed off that, you know, nigga in the world, man. All right? Mm-hmm. Shed off that spick in the world, man. All right?
Yep.
Go ahead.
It says, the old man, which is corrupt, according to the deceitful lusts.
Yeah, so that old man is corrupt. The deceitful lust, man. What were the lusts that we had in the world, you know? Being evil, man. Being wicked, so to speak, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. That's what it is, being wicked.
Yeah.
You know?
Esau made our people live in a fantasy world, man. Mm-hmm. And what's worse is that they have the pride of it. They have the pride of being a, I don't know, Chicano, or the pride of being a black man in America.
Well, like that, you know, Jake say black pride, brown pride.
Right.
No, man. You know? Not supposed to be that. You know?
No.
First off, what is black? What is brown? Those are colors, man.
No need to be prideful.
Right. Go ahead.
Verse 23, it says, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and we do that by what? Not being conformed to this world, but, you know, being renewed, man, through the words of Yahweh, Yahweh Shai. Mm-hmm. That's how you get that. That's that baptism, all right? Being cleaned by the washing of the water of the word. It's also in Ephesians as well.
Yep.
You know, the water of the word. Go ahead.
Yeah, it's a process.
Yep, it's a process.
Last verse, verse 24.
Mm-hmm.
It says, and that ye put on the new man,
yep.
which after the heavenly Father is created in righteousness and true holiness.
There you go, right? It says that you put on the new man, which after the Most High is created in righteousness and true holiness.
Mm-hmm.
Well, how is that so? Through the word, man. The scriptures say in, I believe it's in Psalms, how shall a young man cleanse his way? By taking heed thereto according to thy word, man. That's how you're going to be cleansed. That's how you're going to put on that new man.
Yeah.
And we've gone into that part, you know, we've gone into that before, man, in other lessons, you know. But hey, tying it all back, man, shed off that template Esau set for you, man. You don't have to fit the stereotype, all right? You got to be who the Lord wants you to be, man.
Yeah.
All right, so that's it.
I mean, you know, just to end it off, I just want to add on, too, because mm-hmm. if that means if you're living in the lie, that means you're holding back the spirit.
Yeah.
You're holding back what truth, with who you are. Yeah, who you are, mm-hmm. essentially. You know? And that just goes hand in hand with being honest with yourself. You know, it's putting off. It's probably in your mind, you know, because I know for a fact I have those thoughts of, you know, mm-hmm. fitting the stereotypes.
Yeah.
What's the fact that you think, you know, if you think you're putting it off, people might think you're weird, but really, that's just how the Lord made you.
Yep.
The Lord is the Father of spirits. You think he's not going to have diverse spirits?
Right.
12 tribes, you know, mm-hmm. in each one of those Israelite souls is different and unique in their own way. Mm-hmm. That's what it is. It's unique.
Yeah.
You know, not every Judite is going to be the same Judite.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, a Gadite is not going to have. And not every guy is going to have feathers in their as a headband.
Yeah, right.
play the flute or something, you know.
Play the drums or something, oh, right. You know.
So, we're all diverse, man. We got Yasher Aleph.
Yeah.
Crying out loud, you know.
Prince of the Power.
Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Prince of the Power, yep. All right, Ace. Lord willing, man, this was edifying. Lord willing, it gets to who it needs to reach, man. We want to give all the praises, glory, and honor to Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushai, Ba'ashem, Kakadash. Double honors to the elders and apostles, a great millstone, man, who taught us his truth. And a sincere shalom, barakim, la, bakarim, yasharala, peace and blessings to the elect of Israel. Shalom.
Shalom.